Good morning out there, everyone, or evening, wherever you are. Andrew Tahako here with TNT Group, posting this webcast for NakedTrader.com. The date is January 26, 2011, and it's about 5:45 here in Chicago. Not much stuff going on overnight, news-wise or really market movers. The biggest news out there was the Bank of England minutes came out, and they had their vote about raising rates or keeping them unchanged or things like that. They did come out, as expected, to leave rates unchanged at 50 basis points. However, there was some hawkish tones when they came out and mentioned things, as well as the actual vote. I believe, and I'm not sure about this, you'd have to check it out, but I believe the last vote came in at 8-1 to leave rates unchanged at the 50 basis points. This vote came in at 7-2. There was some hawkish, you know, rhetoric after that too. So, you know, keep an eye on that going forward. That was pretty much the major news overnight. There wasn't any European numbers or anything like that. So once again, keep an eye on the BOE minutes. Take a look at them, you know, before you start trading, and kind of how you want to attack that aspect of things. If you kind of keep a close eye on England and what they're doing. Pretty much the whole trade overnight was just equity straight up. And debt straight down. You really didn't have any movements otherwise. It was barely any pullbacks in the equity markets and barely any rallies in the debt markets. I wanted to be long Euro stocks in the beginning of the night, and they just wouldn't go, and they wouldn't go. And I tried playing defense just because they just wouldn't go. They just sat down by the lows. I ended up getting max long Euro stocks. Really liked them, but they just wouldn't go, and things started moving ways, and I just tried to play defense, and I got walloped, just trying to play defense against my max long Euro stocks. And I'm starting to realize that you just can't do that. You just have to stick with your one your main thought and your one main plan and go with it. And if you're wrong and you think you're wrong, then get out of it, and hopefully it doesn't get you too bad. But like last night, I just tried to play defense, and there is no defense. It's these things continue, and they just take a while to develop, really. Ended up taking just a small winner on my Euro stocks, but because I got blasted trying to play defense, you know, I got myself in a hole right away in the night. Eventually, you know, I think I bought, it was the dead low in the Euro stocks pretty much. I was buying 75s, 74s, and 72s in the Euro stocks. The low is 29.70, and the high now in the overnight's 29.95. So, I mean, we saw a 20-25 tick rally, but it's kind of when you least expected it. As soon as I got out and was like, okay, I don't know why these aren't going, and things started turning around a little bit, that's when it decided to go. So, once again, it's a little of that waiting game and kind of figure out if you're still right or wrong. I was still right. I just ended up thinking I was wrong or just didn't think they were going to go. But overall, I thought there was some play to be bullish on these equities overnight. Trader1806 on Twitter. His Twitter name is Trader1806. Real good guy on Twitter to kind of keep an eye on if you follow people on Twitter. Overnight, he keeps a keen eye on all the European stuff. Real good market commentary stuff. Always talking about levels he has. All the debt auctions that come out, he's really on top of that stuff. But I was talking to him a little bit about the boons overnight, and he had a spot 123.70 to 123.75 in the boons as a pretty large support area. We did go trade down there. I think the low at the time was 120.73, and we bounced about 10-15 ticks right around there in the off the lows. Just a straight pop right off of that. So it was a good level at first. Came back down, tested again, and rallied a little bit. But then ended up breaking the third time down. And right now we're trading 123.65, and the low is 123.55. So if we start trading back up to that level, it could be a key level to hold on the way back up. Again, 123.70 to 123.75 in the March 2011 boons. So keep an eye on that level. It did hold once there. Actually held twice the second time also a little bit, but broke the third time. That's it from here. There's nothing to really talk about too much. No news really besides the BOE stuff. And then pretty much the majority of what I saw overnight was just trying to be patient with stuff, and that's starting to be the name of the game, is just get your main thought, your main idea, and just try and hold it and see if it pans out, and know where you want to get out, know your reasonings and when you think those reasonings turn, and gotta be patient. This stuff is taking a long time to really pan out, and if you've been following my webcasts, I kind of been talking about that a lot, of just sitting on your hands and letting your idea pan out. And if you're patient with it usually pays you. But if you're not, like overnight playing defense, you get smoked and have to rally back during the rest of the night or the morning. That's it from here. Andrew Tahako with TNT Group, posting for NakedTrader.com. Here's a good trading, and good luck the rest of the day. Thanks.